again, we come to a level of expectations, and this takes us into our first topic, which is NFL Sunday Ticket and streaming. The expectations levels are you know, the MLS game went down, and you saw some people upset about it on social media. If this happened with traditional media, if this happened during the rise of cable TV, you wouldn't see all these rights going to cable TV, or at least you would see it going a lot slower than normal out there. I'm really surprised that they didn't that YouTube TV didn't have something in place in terms of rebates or even messaging if this happened. DirecTV had it down to, you know, DirecTV wasn't a beloved service provider either, but they had it down to a science where if there was a hiccup, then they would offer rebates, or they would have the messaging getting out there almost immediately. This is what went wrong, and this is why it went wrong. And I was really surprised to see all of the complaints about YouTube all day long throughout Sunday, and there was really nothing that YouTube was doing to counteract those messages.
Yeah, I think it might have been an overall problem with YouTube in general, but again, they have not responded as of yet. So this is a bigger issue that you're getting at, and you know, it comes into one of the other topics we have is the NBA deal and where that goes. I mean, how much do you think, when you look at the equation for these leagues, money is one thing, of course, that probably wins the day. But then in terms of delivery and the amount of people and reach, you know, where do you see that? And where do you think that Google and YouTube, are they players when we think about the NBA? And you know, again, it's just one day. And before that, they'd really done well. Sunday Ticket, it came out of the gate, you know, pretty good. But how do you look at that?
As it pertains specifically to the NBA, and I think you can throw the NFL in here, and I think that we saw this also with the Big Ten and some of the bigger college conferences, they still prioritize the reach that broadcast television can bring. So with the NBA, I right now in 2023, I find it unthinkable that they would take their biggest events, which would be, you know, the championship series and probably the conference final series of the playoffs, and put those exclusively to a streaming service. I think that would take I think that would take a really big leap. Could that change in 5 years or 6 years for the next NBA rights deal down the road? You know, we see where the trend lines are going. They're certainly headed that way. But yeah, is YouTube a player? I think they're a player if they're interested in getting into sports and they can carve out an NBA package. I think that they would be a player, and I think the NBA, if it's a package of games where it's almost like a test where you get, you know, like $1 billion and you're testing it out there. Yeah, I think that works, so long as it's not really a big game that audiences, you know, want to see, like the NBA Finals.
Well, you had said in your newsletter, I think this is kind of another advantage. We talked about Amazon not having issues in terms of, or major issues in terms of getting the Thursday Night Football on the air. But another thing is that Amazon Prime has huge reach, right? It reaches a lot of people. Now, I don't know if we have the exact numbers, but I feel like they're in like the 70, 80 million range in terms of how many people have it. Maybe it's higher than that. And so I when you talk about the ratings, I mean, you have to be able to reach people. Like Apple TV Plus, again, they don't release their exact numbers, but, you know, the reports, again, take these with a grain of salt because they don't release the numbers. We don't have official numbers. I think are in the 30 to 40 million range for Apple TV Plus. I mean, that's not a lot of reach. And so you're asking, if you're the NBA and you go with Apple, you're asking to do a lot of work. Now, obviously, they have a great distribution system. They're sending me notifications for all kinds of sports. I don't know how to turn that off. I'd like to turn that off, Apple. You could teach me how to
Thank
do that.
Thank God I have that off. I don't get those notifications.
I get notifications. And then it sent me the Celtic game, but it didn't send me to the right. I couldn't, not where it was on. It turned me to like a local RSN. I was like, no, I don't get that.
But part of that story I wrote was the post-game show on a streaming service after Thursday Night Football. So it's a school night, a work night, and it's going pushing up to midnight. They're getting close to 2 million viewers for that, which is a number that you would expect for a broadcast channel or for ESPN, maybe even beyond that. I mean, it's
but I think if you do a compelling show, and that show's pretty good, if you do a compelling show, I do think the one thing streaming really has an advantage long term. It's really hard to turn the channel, and we're all lazy. Like, I know we don't, we are. I mean, it's not, you don't want to be, but, you know, if you want to watch Van Pelt on ESPN, it takes like effort at that point. You know, that's why those ratings for Van Pelt, especially, like, obviously he does a good job, but, you know, he's helped very much by being after big events and being featured that way and having that lead in, which, you know, leads probably to audience, you know, trying it out and then making it a habit. But so I think it does make some sense that they do well because the show is pretty good.
Like, I want to make one point about there have been a lot of reports out about how much money YouTube TV is losing on NFL Sunday Ticket. I think they have 1.5 million subscribers, and there have been a couple reports out there suggesting that they're losing close to $2 billion on this deal.
Is that good?
It's a shell game, Andrew.
It depends on how you define it. That sounds good to me. Losing $2 billion sounds bad to me, but I don't know. I never took any finance.
Look, that's quite a loss leader there. They did this deal in order to grow the subscriber base of YouTube TV. And so if YouTube TV ends up getting more subscribers than Dish Network, which is, there's a good potential for that. All of a sudden, all of the deals that they have with Disney and with Paramount and with Fox, they get better rates because they become a bigger virtual MVPD out there. And so the question is how much they're gaining from doing that, or how much they have to potentially gain from doing that. And we don't know quite the answer to that. So that big headline of, oh, they're losing $2 billion on Sunday Ticket, it's not really $2 billion. We just don't know what that is yet.